to Just JD. Thank you for tuning into my channel today. As y'all can see, we have some sexiness going on here. I decided to switch it up on my channel and do a makeup tutorial today. Yo, I'm not a makeup artist. Doing this makeup tutorial actually made me realize I need to invest in new brushes because my makeup game is a little weak, but I thought that this look turned out so good. As you see, your girl is feeling herself. So if anybody needs a sexy Valentine's Day look, I thought this was fun and super easy to do. You don't have to be a makeup artist. I am not a makeup artist. Sorry, the weave. So if you want to see this look, and I also give a different lip option if this is too much, but honey, ask for anything in this outfit. But there is a second lip option, so if you guys want to see, stay tuned. Hey guys, just jumping right in. I did my brows off camera because your girl takes some time for me to do my brows. But now I'm going in with a kind of a translucent powder. It's got a little bit of a yellow undertone. I saw this on TikTok and actually thought it was pretty cool. It's moisturizer, then translucent powder, then you spray your setting spray. That's the Urban Decay All Nighter. And then you let that sit. But I actually wanted a little bit more, I guess. And then you're going to go in with your primer after you do all that. Honestly, it really does give you a flawless canvas if you're doing sort of like a full face type makeup look for camera. And then I'm just going to put this primer where I need it most, which is my T-zone area. You can see like I'm already, you know, pretty oily there. Plus, you know, I just did a setting spray. All right, next I'm gonna go in with my e.l.f. Hydrating Concealer. It is a full coverage concealer. I actually thought it'd be a little bit lighter, but it does work for camera days such as today. I'm just gonna go in and sculpt right up under my brows. I know that you've probably seen this 1,000 times. Honestly, this just helps the brows like stand out, look like you got them freshly threaded. I don't get my eyebrows waxed because I barely have any enough eyebrows to get them waxed. So yep, just going in super detailed, and I am gonna go on the top. I normally don't bring it all the way down, but I did for the sake of this video. I just wanted my brows to be super on fleek for y'all, super sculpted and defined for my standards. But honestly guys, my makeup has changed a lot in the way that I like it to look, and I usually end up going for a more natural look, but for Valentine's Day I was like, okay, let's just kind of amp it back up like the old days. All right, next I'm going right back in with that e.l.f. Hydrating Concealer on my eyelids. I actually use a dry beauty blender to blend that out because I feel like when you wet it, it does sheer out the coverage, and I kind of want full coverage on my eyes for my primer so that the colors will show up more boldly. I have a weird set of eyelids, I say. I love my eyes, but they're somewhat hooded to the point where, you know, if I do a lot of color work on my eyes, you're probably not going to see it when I open my eyes all the way. And if you do, it's usually, you know, kind of in that middle space at the top, and it's weird. So I'll show you guys how I do my eyelids. But next I'm going in with the Huda Beauty baking powder. I forgot what color this is. I will tag it below. But just setting my eyelids so I can go in with that color, with that eyeshadow, so that they will be, you know, bright, vibrant, and popping. All right guys, next up I'm going in with this blush. Yes, I use it for eyeshadow. It is by Black Radiance, and it's some sort of burnt orange color that I love to put in my crease. I only use reds and oranges and warm browns in my crease because I have sort of hooded eyes. That's the color that I want to show up most. So I'm just taking a fluffy brush and doing that all over. All right, going in with the Too Faced Gingerbread Extra Spicy Palette. I love this palette. All types of warms and neutrals like I like. Going in with this more sort of brighter burnt orange on the outer corners of my eye. this is how I'm kind of creating that cat shape. Again, you don't have to put this on super precise because we're gonna put a thick black liner on top. But we are gonna put this on the outer corner. It's gonna help to make a nice transition of the oranges to reds to browns to black. All right, going in with my next shadow slash blush from also Black Radiance and more of a flat top brush going in. I think it's like Wildberry is the color, guys. It's just the bright red. Now I'm putting this, basically this is in my crease, but you guys can see I don't really have a crease, so I'm drawing it in there with the red a little bit lower than where I placed that orange. We're basically kind of doing a warm, smoky eye kind of deal. But I always love to set up my smoky eyes, cat eye looks with like beautiful deep reds, because I feel like when you put the browns in there, your eyes don't get lost within the, you know, the browns and the blacks. So just placing that a little bit lower, creating that crease as y'all can kind of start to see it popping out. But like literally, I have the biggest eyeballs and no crease. It's weird. It's fine though. It's fine. All right, popping back into that gingerbread palette. I'm going in with this rich chocolatey brown right here. Any brown you guys will do that's more of a warm brown. Again, I like warm tones on my skin. This is where I'm gonna try to create somewhat of a crease, but guys, I'm so sloppy with this. This is not a look that you have to be super precise about. Literally where the little fold is, where my eyeball is trying to make a crease, that's where I'm putting this brown. With kind of a flat shade brush. Honestly, this is probably not the best brush to put it in, but this is the one I have, so that's what your girl is using. And literally, I'm just placing it on the outer V, I guess, with the rest of those colors, and then just diffusing that. All right, so as you guys can see, I am dragging that brown down towards my eye. Just to give it a little bit more of a smoky feel, but nothing like super heavy, as you guys can see. And I wish the camera would pick up the color, because the color is so much more rich than this, but it's fine. And then I honestly, if I feel like it's still a little bit too heavy, like you guys know, I do like a little bit more of a natural look. Honestly, take your finger, blend that bad boy out. The warmth from your finger will spread the product, you know, evenly. So just doing that to the same eye, or to the other eye. Here comes my favorite part. I get to go in with black. It is just the regular black from Wet n Wild, and get it at Walgreens, wherever. And then this pointy brush here. So I literally am going to trace the outer parts of my eye where I want the eyeliner to go. And now I'm actually going in and drawing that crease out, and that little fold that I do have. So just doing that real lightly at first, because then I'm gonna go in with a dome brush and actually pack that on. Okay, now going in and packing that color on, like I just said, this is where I get to kind of smoke it out, make it a little bit heavier. Honestly, guys, the black is so much darker than this. I need to figure out, you know, my lighting situation so you guys can see the different colors. But again, I'm not going to take it above the little crease that I have. All right, now I'm going in with the Voluminous Carbon Black L'Oreal Mascara. This is my favorite mascara, guys. Now I'm going in with the Lancome mascara, which the price difference on this is huge. So I only use Lancome for like films and special occasions. But you're gonna go in, take it all the way to the root. I normally don't wear false lashes. I used to, and then they make my eyes look crazy on camera. But yes, and that's, I haven't even lined my eyes yet. Like, look how good that is. All right, here's the star of the show. This is a black liquid liner by Black Radiance. It's the only eyeliner I use because it is so black, it is so dark, and it shows up amazingly. Liner, y'all, took me years to do, but basically I always pull my eyelid down just so I can actually see it.
then I draw a thin line, as you can see I'm doing now, and I just carve out what I want it to look like. And then I will go in like I'm doing now, pulling it tighter and just creating a thicker and thicker line. Once you get your staple line, it's so much easier to go in and make it thicker from the inside. And the outside is where my fingertip is. So just dragging that down, and you just do it little by little so you don't mess it up. But this is the whole reason why I told you guys not to worry about the eyeshadow, because pretty much the liner is covering up almost all of the work that we did. And that's usually what happens because I have those sort of mono eyelids a little bit. All right, now we're going into the face. So I'm using MAC Studio Fix Fluid and then this e.l.f. kind of full coverage foundation, and I'm gonna mix them. And then I have this Afterglow. Literally, guys, you just need a liquid highlighter of some sort. I'm mixing Studio Fix Fluid with the e.l.f. foundation because Fluid has a sheer coverage, more day-to-day, which I love. And I wear it almost every time I wear makeup. And then this e.l.f. primer gives me a little bit more of a full coverage. So I'm gonna mix them and make a medium coverage because my skin doesn't need too much. And I thought about going in with the Afterglow, but the thing I don't like is I don't like mixing the highlighter with my foundation before I put it on my forehead because it gives it a weird sheen across the forehead. So before I put the Afterglow, I'm just going in with the foundation with my finger, warming it up on my skin, placing it over my face, and my hands are clean, just in case you guys were wondering. Okay, then I'm going in with my beauty blender and just blending this out, gives it a nice coverage. And guys, you guys would have seen, if I put the highlighter in there already, it would have made the forehead look super, I don't know, it just gives it a weird cast. I don't like it. So now I'm going in, if I can find it, the Afterglow. So any liquid highlighter you guys have, mix it with your foundation. And normally, guys, I do put a drop of oil in there too, but I forgot about it this time, which kind of gives it a more dewy kind of full coverage finish. But just going in with the stippling brush. And if I want a full coverage look, I do use a stippling brush and not just a beauty blender because it will sheer it out. But just going all over my face. All right, now I'm going in with the e.l.f. Hydrating Concealer, I think it is. And I forgot what color it is, but I will try to put it below. It's kind of a toffee color. And I learned this the other day. So you don't like put a whole triangle under your eyes, which is what I thought I was supposed to do, did for years. But you just put a dot under the eye and then two on the outer corner. And what I always do is I always put setting spray on my beauty blender before blending out my eyes, just so it's not super cakey, because I do get a little creasing under my eyes if I don't do this step. So anybody who experiences creasing, try spraying your beauty blender with setting spray and then blending it out. And no, you are not crazy hearing that cat meow. That is my cat Vashti trying to make her debut on my channel. I'm doing my voiceover. Okay, so just blending that out. Now I'm going in with the same shade and putting it around my nose. I get a lot of oiliness and creasing around my nose area. So I learned to go in again just a little bit. Guys, you don't need a ton of product. You just kind of need a lot of little, if that makes sense. So just putting that around my mouth, my nose, and blending that out. Now I'm going in with the brighter version of this. It's kind of a honey color. It's really going to give me that kind of Kim K under eye brightness that we all used to do back in the day. Shout out to Kim K. She's a makeup OG. Still putting it in the same spot, but you guys will watch and see how much brighter that my face gets after blending this out. So just going in. All right, here is a trick and an important step in my makeup routine. I take my favorite setting sprays and I spray them on my face throughout the process. And this helps it to give a overall flawless smooth setting finish. I learned this from Jaclyn Hill. She was always teaching that you want to layer the product. So after you do cream or after you do powder, you want to spray it so that it gets a more transitional finish and not so stark. Now I'm going in with, again, Black Radiance. I love their products. It is a foundation stick I'm using as a contour stick. Just hitting all my normal spots. You guys know contour. I love nose contour. It's my favorite thing ever. Now taking this half of an e.l.f. brush, right? And blending out my nose first. Guys, when you're blending out your nose, take your time. Obviously, I sped through this for the video. And I don't draw two lines all the way down. I do halfway, and then I do the bridge of my nose to accentuate it, because I already do have a small nose. But when you do it right up under where your nose is, where the bridge is, it kind of pulls it and points it out, gives you that cute little, I call it bunny rabbit nose. That's what I call it. All right, now when I'm blending, I go up. You always kind of want to do an upward motion. And blending this takes a really long time. I usually get really impatient with it, but it's cool. And then when I'm doing my chin, I always go under my chin, guys, because sometimes I feel like I have a very weak jawline and I would like it to be stronger. So I do take a little extra time on the jawline to blend it out. And guys, when I'm blending out my cheeks, you want to blend the top of it so that you can still kind of have a sharp line, how I kind of created there, and then you can go back and soften it later. All right, so now I'm actually going to go back in with the correct angled face brush to soften and blend out the rest of this line. Honestly, I do like a tad bit of a harsher contour line. To accentuate my cheekbones. My face is very angled but flat at the same time, if you guys see what I'm saying. Like, I have high cheekbones, but you can't always see them, so I do accentuate them. Now I'm just going in with my beauty blender. I have already sprayed it with some setting spray. Guys, if the one thing you learn from my channel or my makeup tutorials is to blend, 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 and spray, spray, spray. Okay, going in with the Huda Beauty Powder to bake under my eyes and all of my contour lines. And guys, I don't normally bake. I usually just kind of set it, but for the purpose of doing a bomb Valentine's Day look, I definitely went in and baked. And guys, you just bake, you put that powder right under where the contour is, and then you put it right up under your eyes where you had your concealer. This helps it to stay all day and to make those contour lines a little bit more bold. So I go back in with that palette and that same brown that I put in my eyes, and I actually go back in over, put some powder where the contour lines were. When you put powder over cream, which is what I use for contour sticks and things like that, it actually helps it to stay all day and the color to stick and be a little bit brighter. So that is just what I'm doing here. And then I definitely do go under my jawline to sculpt that out. Now I'm going in and erasing everything, and you guys can just see how crisp that line is, which I absolutely love. I know some people hate that. That just lets me know that my contour did its thing, it did its job. And so just brushing all of that off. Probably some of that powder got in my eye, guys. That's why I made that weird face. All right, boom, flawless. But now we need to go back in and soften that contour. So taking that same angled brush. And when you guys are blending, guys, sometimes when I get irritated that it's taking so long, I just start blending any kind of way, and you can't. You always have to blend up. If you blend down, it's going to defeat the purpose of the contour lines. All right, going in with this super bright yellow powder. I'm just putting it where I would put the concealer at, and this is really just going to brighten it. Then I brush it off. Okay, now going in with a cream blush by Fenty. Love, love blush. Ladies, if you guys are not using blush in your routines, you need to add it. Okay, wait, I went a little heavy, but I promise I will blend it out. There we go. Girls, when you add blush to your routine, it literally gives you an extra dimension of shade and color to your face. Obviously, we don't wake up with rosy cheeks, so you will need to blend that bad boy out. But when you do the overall finish and look at the look, it really does help make a difference when you go in with the highlighter. All right, going in with that mascara on the bottom eyelashes. All right, highlight, my favorite part. Guys, my highlighters are all drugstore. I get them from Kim's. It's a hair store here in Nashville. And that other one is Wet n Wild. All right, flat shader brush. Here we go, my favorite part. Nose. I love doing my nose. It just really brings the face together. All right, highlighter on the bottom chin, on top of that blush. You kind of see how I've already blended that out. I could have blended it out a little bit more, but it's fine. All right. And what I like to do, guys, is I layer my highlights. I never, ever use one highlighter because I'm always a big believer in adding dimension to your face. So the first one was rose gold. This one is a gold gold. And it literally just gives you that look that you're, you know, wanting. Look at that. Love it. And again, when you go in, you want to always go up. Everything is more of an upward motion when it comes to contour and highlight. All right, this is actually the star of the show that makes everything look va-va-voom. Going in with a basic red lip liner, probably NYX or NYX, whatever you call it. Then going in with Pretty Kiss. It is my favorite cosmetic brand. They sponsor me with these gorgeous lip shades. And I am normally not a red girl, but honey, do you guys see the color in this? Like, it's really hard to find your shade of red. But honestly, if you have a deeper skin tone like me, you want to go with more of a blue undertone. And I know that's weird, but it gives you, it goes with the skin tone better. So if you guys want this red lip, let me know. Super inexpensive. Okay, now going back in with a brown lip liner. I do this when I feel like it's a little too bold and I want to just make sure it blends with everything. And here is the final look. How cute am I? Like, literally, look. I'm so cute. You cannot not feel yourself after doing this. All right, guys, if you like this look, like, comment, and subscribe. And let me know if you want more. Bye.